الحمد لله رب العالمين نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ونصلي ونسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبع هداه أما بعد. All praises are due to Allah, the creator, the cherisher, and the sustainer of this universe. And may his peace and blessings be upon his noble prophet Muhammad and his companions and descendants and followers, dear respected brothers and sisters. Everything in this world is about relationships. Every one of us is in relationships with different people. We have a relationship with our spouses, relationships with our children, with our neighbors, with fellow Muslims, with people who are non-Muslim. But the issue is, which relationship is the most important relationship of all the relationships in our life? It is definitely the relationship with Allah. When you read the Quran and you see that Allah chose man to be his trustee on earth, from among all the creation, even the angels. And when Allah announced this to the angels, saying, "Inni ja'ilun fil ardi khalifa," I am taking on earth a trustee. They said, "Ataj'alu fiha man yufsidu fiha wa yasfiku ad-dima'a wa nahnu nusabbihu bihamdika wa nuqaddisu lak." Do you make on earth someone who will shed the blood and spread mischief in the land while we glorify you and worship you? So the angels looked for that position. But the decision of Allah was taken. This proves that this relationship is a very, very important and special relationship. The relationship between us and Allah. When you see that Allah is ordering the angels to prostrate down greeting Adam. Of course, that was not to announce a new God or anything, but to announce that this creature is not like any other creature. This is a creature who has superiority in knowledge, even above the angels in knowledge, because the angels were unable to say the names while Adam told them all the names, and they said, "Subhanaka la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana." Glory be unto you, we only know what you taught us. So Allah commands the angels to prostrate down to announce that this is a VIP creature, not like any other creature. So this is definitely the most important relationship in your life, your relationship with Allah. Any relationship, in order to be a successful relationship, both parties of the relationship should understand it fully. And of course, Allah knows you so well. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَهُوَ اللَّهُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ يَعْلَمُ سِرَّكُمْ وَجَهْرَكُمْ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تَكْسِبُونَ. He is Allah in the heavens and in the earth. He knows what you hide and what you reveal. But it's about you. Do you know the terms of this relationship? And talking about the terms of the relationship, brothers and sisters, we need to talk about facts. Because the terms of the relationship with Allah are not negotiable. Those are facts. Fact number one in your relationship with Allah is that Allahu huwa al-khaliq. Allah is the creator. And the Quran emphasized on this point over 1,000 times. Nearly in 15% of the Quran is emphasizing on this point, that Allah huwa al-khaliq, Allah is the creator. Allah mentioned the word ja'ala in the Quran about 300 times. Ja'ala means make or made, in a way that serves the meaning of creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. And we have made from water every living thing. We have made from water. We have created from water. So the word make here serves the meaning of creation. وجعلنا السماء سقفاً محفوظاً سقفاً مرفوعاً. So Allah says, we have made the heavens as a raised ceiling. Make serving the meaning of creation. The word خلق was mentioned over 200 times. خلق, خلقت, خلقنا. All the derivatives of خلق, which means create. And so many other terms that serve the same meaning of creation. Like التصوير, imaging, giving images. هو يصوركم في الأرحام كيف يشاء. الفطر, فاطر السماوات والأرض. البدء, start. هو الذي يبدأ الخلق ثم يعيده. He is the one who started the creation. And so many other terms. Why? Because this is the most important term in the relationship with your creator. Is that Allah is the creator. In Surah Al-Kahf, you see this. In Surah Al-Kahf, there are four main stories. The second story is the story of the man who owns two gardens. An arrogant man who committed kufr because of out of his arrogance, because of his wealth. His Muslim friend is actually reminding him. So he told him, أَكَفَرْتَ بِالَّذِي خَلَقَكَ. He didn't say أَكَفَرْتَ بِالَّذِي رَزَقَكَ. While it's expected that he would tell him, are you committing kufr against the one who provided for you? Because he's arrogant because of his wealth. But no, he is reminding him that Allah created him. Are you committing kufr against the one who created you? Because this is the first term and the most important term in your relationship with Allah. Second, the second fact is that Allah huwa al-malik. Allah is the owner. قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ. Say, oh Allah, the owner of the dominion. You give ownership to whom you will and you take ownership from whom you will. You give whom you will and you deprive whom you will. He is the owner. The owner of everything. He owns us and what we own. The money in your pocket, the money in your account belongs to Allah. Doesn't belong to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran about the slaves, to help slaves buy their own freedom. وَآتُوهُم مِّن مَالِ اللَّهِ الَّذِي آتَاكُمْ. And give them out of the wealth of Allah that He gave to you. So your money is not really your money. You are a supplementary, you are given access to this money in order to be tested. Like when you have an account in the bank and you make a supplementary credit card for your child or for your wife. Supplementary, he's not the real owner. Just supplementary, and you are monitoring what he will, or she will be, how they will use the money. You are not the owner of your own possessions. And subhanallah, who said that we're not owners? We are also owners of some things. We own some things. This leads us to fact number three, which is Allahu huwa alladhi lahu sultan. He is the one who has full control. Even if you own some things, you don't have full control on them because you're not the real owner. You don't have full control. Imagine with me that you have a piece of land where there are trees, apple trees. Who is the owner of the apples? Should be you as the owner. No. You don't have control. Can you control the amount of apples? You can't. You don't have a button to push and say, I want 6.4 tons of apple this year. You cannot. Can you control the quality of the apples? No. Who has the full control? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has full control. فَسُبْحَانَ الَّذِي بِيَدِهِ مَلَكُوتُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. Glory be unto Him who is in control of everything, and you will all return back to Him. Subhanallah. Fact number four in your relationship with Allah is that Allah huwa al-Razzaq. He is the sustainer. He provides for us. And He provides for the fish in the streams. And He provides for the birds in the skies. He provides for even organisms that you cannot see with your naked eye. He is the sustainer. The one who provides for everyone. لَهُ مَقَالِيدُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ يَبُسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. إِنَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. He is the one who provides abundantly to whom he wills. He is the one who gives us, brothers and sisters. Fact number five in your relationship with Allah. Allahu huwa al-hadi. Allah is the guide. رَبُّنَا الَّذِي أَعْطَى كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلْقَهُ ثُمَّ هَدَى. This is how Prophet Musa and Harun explained to Fir'aun, their Lord. He is the one who created everything and then he guided. Because actually, creation without guidance means chaos. But creation plus guidance plus resurrection after death means a strong system. And we are living in a strong system, brothers and sisters. Don't believe those ignorant people who say everything in this world came by chance, came by coincidence. We believe that nothing in this world came by chance. Not one thing came by chance. Nothing is by coincidence. Not once a mango tree gave grapes by coincidence. Not once, brothers and sisters. This is a strong system. Creation, guidance, and then resurrection after death. أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do you think that I created you in vain and that you are not returning back to me? And he said, إِنَّا كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَاهُ بِقَدَرٍ. Everything was created in proportion and measure. And fact number six in your relationship with Allah, brothers and sisters, is that Allah is the all-wise and the all-aware. Al-Hakim al-Khabir. He wasn't trying, so he found us. Allah is the all-wise and the all-aware. وَلَا يُشْرِكُ فِي حُكْمِهِ أَحَدًا. He doesn't consult with others. After all this, brothers and sisters, after all this, don't you think that he has the right to command, to order us? Believe me, brothers and sisters, all of the relationship of Allah is summarized in a very short verse in the Quran, which is, four words. أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ. By his command is the creation and the command. He created and he guided and he provided and he sustained. And then he is commanding us. So his part was done perfectly. Did we do our part? Did we follow the command of Allah? Do we obey Allah? After all this, we don't obey Allah actually. We don't support the oppressed. Still, we don't stay away from the haram. Still, we don't. And then what happened? Do we see him punishing us? Subhanallah. After all this, he is so patient. Because he is the patient one. And he sends us messages, brothers and sisters. He doesn't send it to your mobile phones, inbox messages, or to your inbox of your email. Sometimes you're out of reach. But he sends it to an inbox that you carry with you all the time, to your heart. It's in the Quran. Messages that are very tender. Because this Quran is a divine broadcasting. Playing 24/7. If you're not hearing it, then your receiver is not tuned. Tune your receiver and you will start receiving the broadcasting, the divine broadcasting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, and we are sinners, he tells us, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ. Say, O my slave servants who transgressed against their own souls, despair not of the mercy of Allah, for Allah forgives all sins, and return back to him. Subhanallah. He doesn't need to send us those messages. Wallahi, Allah treats us as if he doesn't have servants except us. And we treat him as if we have so many gods except him. Well, actually, it's the opposite. We don't have except one God, and he has so many except us. And he can change us and bring others. But he is treating us very tenderly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ. He sees you sinning, committing sins, and he tells you, hasn't the time arrived for the believers, for their hearts to engage in all humility, in the remembrance of al-haq, the truth, and my remembrance? He said, escape. But he didn't say escape from me. He said, escape to me. فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. Escape to Allah. He didn't say from Allah. Escape to Allah. SubhanAllah. Again, brothers and sisters, this relationship is about what? You see here that Allah treats us with love. So this is a relationship of love. Before anyone says, hey, is this bid'ah or what? This is in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهَ. Say, if you really love Allah, then follow my command, Allah would love you. So to understand this, there are three scenarios of a relationship with Allah. There is the scenario of fear, and the scenario of hope or greed, and the scenario of love. The scenario of fear is to do the good and stay away from evil, to do the halal and stay away from the haram, because you fear the punishment of Allah in this life and in the hereafter. Good. There's another scenario of greed. I call it greed, which is actually hope. You do the good, you stay away from evil because you want the blessing of Allah in this life and in the hereafter. Still good, very good. But the best scenario is the scenario of love. You do the good, you stay away from evil because you love Allah. You go to pray because you are eager to stand up between His hands. There are two types of salah. Salah that comforts you and a salah that you are comforted from. The salah that comforts you is the salah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is 10 minutes for Maghrib, 5 minutes, 3 minutes, 2 minutes, 1 minute now. رِحْنَا بِهَا يَا بِلَال. Go ahead, Bilal. Comfort us. So the salah that you wait for is the salah that comforts you. But this one, oh my God, there's only 5 minutes left for Maghrib. Let's quickly catch Maghrib. And then you pray at the last moment and then, alhamdulillah. This is salah that you are comforted from. This is not the salah of Prophet Muhammad. I don't want to be misunderstood and anyone say that I said that we should not fear Allah or hope to go to Jannah. No. I said that the first scenario should be in your relationship with Allah is love. And then comes fear and then comes hope. Because those who worship Allah only through fear, they fell into the bid'ah of al-khawarij. And those who worshiped Allah through only hope fell into the bid'ah of al-murji'. And that's another issue, another topic. But this is something very important, brothers and sisters. I pray to Allah that He grants us His love and the love of whom He loves and the love of every deed that gets us closer to His love. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that every human being is a sinner and the best of sinners are those who repent. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ونصلي ونسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبع هداه. It is very important, brothers and sisters, very important to focus on those relationships. Number one, the relationship with Allah, as we said. And number two comes the relationship with yourself. You consist of four things. Every one of us consists of four main things. And Allah gave us those things either weak or empty. And He gave us tools to either fill it up or strengthen them. mind or intellect, aql, qalb, heart, ruh, soul, and body, jasad. Aql, qalb, ruh, jasad. Intellect, heart, soul, and a body. Every one of those was given to you weak or empty, and he gave you the tools to strengthen them or fill them up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, هو الذي أخرجكم من بطون أمهاتكم لا تعلمون شيئا. He is the one who got you out from your mother wombs knowing nothing. Empty minds. Empty minds. وجعل لكم السمع والأبصار والأفئدة لعلكم تشكرون. And he gave you hearing sense, seeing sense, and intellect so that you may be able to be thankful. So he gave you tools to fill up those minds with the right information and with the right aqidah and with the right knowledge. Same thing. The Prophet ﷺ said that every human being, every newborn is born on a state of fitrah, innate nature. And then his parents make him a Jew or a Christian or a Magan. He didn't say or a Muslim, because he was born on a state of fitrah, Muslim. So we believe, we don't believe that we were born with an original sin like others. No, we believe that we were born with an original goodness, with a good heart, ready for Iman. But you need to charge it with Iman. It's like the battery of a mobile. You have to charge it every day. If you don't charge it, it dies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَنَفْسِ وَمَا زَكَّاهَا فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that he gave us a soul or a spirit ready for either to be immoral or very moral. It's up to you how you deal with it, the tarbiyah. And that's why starting today, inshallah, or tonight, inshallah, we will start workshops. The first workshop is like a 9 weeks workshop, which is called Tarbiyah Imaniyah, after Isha, inshallah, which is how to upbring and nourish your heart and charge it with Iman. When it finishes, inshallah, we start spiritual Tarbiyah. How to attain sincerity and humble and humility. I wish to see you all in these workshops, inshallah. Allahumma arzuqna hubbak wa hubba man yuhibbuk wa hubba kull 'amalin yuqarribuna ila hubbik. Allahumma ma razaqtana ma tuhib faj'alhu quwwatan lana fi ma tuhib wa ma zawaita 'anna mimma tuhib faj'alhu faraghan lana fi ma tuhib. Allahumma ij'alna nuhibbuka bi kulli qulubina wa kulli 'uqulina wa kulli quwwatina. اللهم جنبنا الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم لا تسلط علينا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من كل متكبر جبار. اللهم من أرادنا والإسلام والمسلمين بخير فوفقه إلى كل خير، ومن أرادنا والإسلام والمسلمين بسوء فاجعل اللهم تدميره تدبيره، واجعل الدائرة عليه ورد كيده في نحره. هو الله، do not condemn us if we forget or fall into error. O Allah, do not lay on us a burden greater than we have the strength to bear. O Allah, do not lay on us a burden like that which you did lay on those before us. O Allah, forgive us. Erase our sins from our records. O Allah, you are our protector. Grant us victory over the evildoers and over ourselves. O Allah, we have heard the call of one calling us to faith. Believe in your Lord, and we believed. O Allah, we came to you with so many sins that may fill up this earth. But your mercy and forgiveness are greater, so forgive us and forgive our sins. O Allah, grant us what you promised us through your messengers. O Allah, save us from the shame of the day of judgment. O Allah, save the Muslim blood. O Allah, save the Muslim children. O Allah, save the Muslim souls. O Allah, whoever plans to do good for the Muslims, help him and bless his deeds. O Allah, whoever plans to do harm for the Muslims, make his plots return on him and make his destruction in his own plans, and show us in him your signs. O Allah, grant us your love and the love of whom you love, and the love of every deed that gets us closer to your love. Oh Allah, we seek your protection from anxiety and sorrow. Oh Allah, we seek your protection from helplessness and laziness. Oh Allah, we seek your protection from cowardice and miserliness. Oh Allah, we seek your protection from the burden of debts and the tyranny of man. Oh Allah, we seek your protection from disbelief and poverty. Oh Allah, we seek your protection from the punishment of the grave. Oh Allah, you are our Lord. There is no God but you. You created us and we are your slave servants. And we uphold your pledge and promise as best as we can. We seek your protection against the evil that we have committed. And we acknowledge your blessings upon us. And we acknowledge our sins. So forgive us, for no one forgives sins except you. Oh Allah, we are your servants. We raised our hands asking your protection and guidance. Oh Allah, do not return our hands back empty. وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ